Boom, guys. Listen, another day, another question from you to answer. Listen, I'm here to provide my value for you. If you want to ask a question yourself, go to the Jot form down below in the description, or you can just comment down below, or you can go to my community tab where I first posted this thread and comment there, all right? If you do use the form, by the way, you don't have to use your name. So that's, you know, if you have any, you know, nitty gritty details you don't want out in a comment, use the link, use the form. Today's question comes from the Sergio K. The Sergio OK, I think. Sergio K. I hear people say, for example, when they break up or something bad happens, they're always in demon mode or just angry or pissed, always. Well, I've gone through a breakup recently. I do feel pissed or angry, those emotions that you usually feel, but it's not like how people describe it. It's like for 5 or 10 seconds, but then it goes away. I want to have that focus and drive to use it to become better, so I can get in that zone and stay there. Very interesting, very interesting. First of all, sorry for your breakup. It's the best thing that could happen to you. It's good. It's good that you can draw from that anger and pain. I use this a lot, all right? I draw from anger and pain a lot. I don't talk about this a lot, all right? But I'll do it for you guys, all right? Listen, sometimes when I'm out running, when I need a bit of extra, you know, punch, I think of bad stuff. It's nice. It's like, you ever heard of like what David Goggins did? He recorded all his haters' comments to himself. He like, you know, read them while he recorded it, and then he would listen to it when he was running. Huh? It's cool, huh? I kind of want to try that myself. Listen, but I don't have that many haters because, you know, I'm a phenomenal specimen of a human. So maybe that comment itself will get some haters. I don't know. Haters, if you're watching this, feel free in the comments. I need some fuel. But, I mean, you say it's like for 5 or 10 seconds and then it goes away. But you want that focus and drive to use it to become better. So, I mean, it's kind of like you start thinking about it for, that's what I do. You start thinking for about for a second and then like the fire comes up underneath it. Like I think about bad stuff and then it's like, doosh. I imagine myself punching through a brick wall or something. So it's not like I go around and, think about the bad stuff the whole way. I think about the bad stuff and then that gives me the fuel and then, I feel like an absolute Spartan. So, for 5 or 10 seconds, you have the drive and you use it to become better, but you want to stay in that zone. You want to get in the zone and stay there. When it comes to finding that flow state, that zone that you want to be in, you need to recognize exactly what gets you there. So exactly what thoughts got you to that place. Where were you? How were you feeling? What were you wearing? All this stuff, I swear to God, this is so powerful for mindset in general. Like if you, because you can recognize, the body recognizes, or the mind recognizes, rather, that like, okay, let's say you're in a scenario, and like this is how, I'm not a psychologist, but if you see a dead cat by the road, the emotions that you feel like, if you go back to the road, like the same emotions are gonna come back, right? And so you can use this in a good way. You can use this in a good way. So I want you to think back exactly what, like this girl, what did she tell you? Like when you're in the heat, when you're in the moment, what did you tell you that hurt you? Did the breakup hurt? Right? I want you to imagine that, okay? I want you to use that pain, right? There's plenty more women out there. So, you'll get over this. I mean, it's good that you're using this as fuel. There's no better way of going about it. So that's how I would approach it, right? Think about exactly the thoughts that just gets you that 5 and 10 seconds. And then just recognize it. You need to be conscious, like, holy shit, okay, that power, that drive, what got me there? And like, if you feel like, it's not like you have to go around and think about that all the time, but you can spark, you can use it as a spark, and then the flame comes underneath, and you take over, right? You go blast. That's essentially how you do it, because you don't want to get stuck up on this idea the whole time. You know, that's not a good idea. Thoughts are very interesting. Thoughts are kind of like clouds, okay? And you don't want to obsess too much over rain clouds, okay? You kind of just want to watch them go by like this. Some clouds, which are nice, some thoughts, you can take an extra look at. You can see what shape does the cloud have oh, that looks like a horse, right? So you can obsess over those thoughts. That's nice, right? It's good like that. But for those shitty clouds, you know what I mean? Just let them pass. But, I mean, I think that's it. You go on to say that focus and drive to use to become better so I can get in that stone and stay there. Okay, so break up, but you want to become better. Okay, that's interesting. That's very interesting. Why did the breakup happen? You know, I want to talk about this in another video. But when it comes to like breakups and everything in general, the first thing you do is always look at yourself. What did you do wrong? Not anyone else. It's you. It's always on you because that's all you can change. You can't go back and you can't change the past. So the only thing you can do right now is change yourself. She's like, okay, what happened? What can we go back? What can we, you know, take from this? Did I become a slob? Did I, you know, quit going to the gym? Or did I say something? Right? You can start there at least. And you can, you know, analyze yourself. And that's how you can become better. Like for any scenario, it doesn't have to be breakup. It can be like missing a job interview. I don't know. You slipped and fell. Oh, did you not read the warning sign? It's like a big yellow warning sign there. Now you're embarrassed. You spill coffee over yourself in the lobby of a hotel. It's on you, right? It's not on the hotel staff because they put the thing there. So next time you need to open your eyes, just like that. All right. So that's two for you. Okay. Do those two. Track back to what gets you into that mindset, and to become better, find out exactly what you did wrong. Because we always do wrong stuff. I mean, none of us are perfect. Not even me. I bet you wouldn't believe. I bet you wouldn't believe. That's a cool verse. But that's it for today. All right. Sergio K, thank you so much for the question. Guys, again, if you have questions, drop them down in the jot form, okay? If you don't want to use the name, you know, if you want to just spit a comment out, explain the scenario, or explain the situation, then do that, all right? Can't wait to, you know, provide you guys more value. Take care, and God bless. Boom!